That's what I'm always saying.
I told my son a story. And his question was, when you were out at sea, did you ever get a
party affiliation to vote? Because you never know in these races how close it's going to be.
Well, speaking of the primary, has there been any conversation as to when the appointment to the commission will be made and when that group actually might start meeting, since they have to give an answer by October?
I haven't thought about it yet.
Okay.
I think we have to, I don't think I have to do it until sometime in September. So we haven't, it's work to try to get ahead of all these appointments you do.
Do you think it's a good schedule or way to do it? Because selection has to be done by October 1st. Is that enough time for all the supervisors' elections to have the election in place?
My understanding it is. That's what everything I've been told. So, yeah.
What about insurance? PIP insurance?
It's a real problem. I mean, if you look at PIP insurance, I was on a radio show the other day, and they asked me about that. It's what my belief about insurance I think you ought to give, and whether it's health insurance or home insurance or automobile insurance, we ought to give the buyer as many choices as we can. So, but I think we've got to deal with PIP. Citizens is still an issue that we have in our state. So, as you know, I'm trying to use these cabinet meetings to highlight debt, all the financial things. Well. The way I think about it is that we need to have a safety net if you lose your job, and that makes sense. What we can't do is have it cost so much money that it causes employers not to want to hire somebody, or when they're struggling, have to let somebody go. Because my goal is that we hit the right balance between making sure we have a good safety net and we don't have it so expensive that employers can't pay for it, so they end up ultimately not decide not to hire somebody.